Hello everybody and welcome to Dota Pit Season 4 by G2A. I am Toby1, I am the host for the English live stream tonight. I realized too as well, just as I was sitting down here waiting to start this game, the cap, he was in here last night casting the games, and he ended up having a closer shot, so I'm feeling a little bit personal with the couple in my background right now. A man also, which, no, I don't think I really get personal with him that much, but we do get to love to talk to each other, and that is the guy who was standing in for the man who, unfortunately, some salt came up, and he had to actually attend a meeting, so unfortunately, I do not have PPD casting with me tonight, but don't worry, I'm going to try and get him to actually cast a couple of other games with me in the future, so don't fear, but luckily, I have the man. He fights on the streets. It is Ryu. Welcome, man. Hi! Hello.
I mean, being second best to PPD.
You are the replacement. You are the replacement.
Replacing a TI champion, I feel honored actually. So, and I actually do watch PPD streams too, because it's nice perspective to watch somebody else casting from a support role, or you know, say somebody else casting from a core role, and it's really insightful. The way he talks about, you know, just generating a lot of space on the map as a support player and just going around. So it's really informative still watching him cast.
Man, I kind of wish we got to have him more times. Actually, I'm still waiting for his analysis of MDL. I know
he has a lot of vlogs now, and it's very impressive.
Yeah, I watched all of the vlogs apart from one, because thank you to GEMEA for all the Germans out there who are tuning in right now. They know what to say to that. Scheiße. But I was watching his vlogs, and he didn't actually really talk about the drafts themselves. Like, I love his end of tournament like reviews of the meta, the drafting, what happened there, and so on and so forth. Like, the only thing you got out of the MDL vlogs was, well, the event was kind of shite. Things were wrong, but considering everything that went wrong, we kind of did well, even though we played badly and had some things which we were tested on, and that was kind of it. So, yeah, it was. I'm still waiting for the juicy stuff at the end of it. But let's focus on our game right now, man, because Team Spirit versus Na'Vi. Now, Spirit, in their WePlay game, they played against Na'Vi, which only happened maybe 1.5-2 hours ago. Were defeated in 20 minutes by Na'Vi.
It was like death ball versus death ball. and then one side won.
I looked at that game, man, and the ball that Na'Vi was holding was a lot bigger and a lot stronger.
Oh, yeah. It was like a draw ranger. Well, that was pretty useless strategy that we tried it out, and it didn't work out.
You know, it was funny because I poked my head into the chat during that game, and everyone was instantly like, man, how's it feel? You're watching Draw Ranger lose. and I'm just like, okay, guys, okay. She deserves to lose in so many games. Like, that's not where my weird fetish comes. She deserved to lose that game. There's so many of these games. Like, she had a game against her, which was a Lycan game, I think it was. The team that I think it was played by Team Spirit, actually. They played a Lycan against a Draw Ranger, and it ended up being like this 40-50 minute match. And like, what do you do as a Draw Ranger? Like, you gust back a Lycan, and he just keeps running at you. It's like, you just don't care. She really just does become like a 4 position at that point, even if you had her as a 1. So yeah, she deserved to lose that last game. But Na'Vi, they haven't lost any game since Star Ladder. At the same time, they haven't played up against any tier 1/high tier 2 teams. In saying that, though, maybe I should take that back, as Team Spirit did qualify for the major, and Team Spirit was one of the teams they faced up against. So maybe I should take that back a little bit.
I think you're right, though, in the assessment where Team Spirit has been looking very shaky ever since they did get qualified. So maybe teams have started figuring them out. Or they just aren't really performing that well all of a sudden. So it's kind of weird to say. One thing, though, that I know that is certain is General plays Batrider, and pretty much only Batrider, it seems, for Na'Vi. Oh, man.
I got to look through his hero list right now.
It's like Batrider and Void.
Well, so what do we have? We have Beastmaster, which you played in the Wii Play game earlier today. Then it's Batrider.
Yeah, Bat.
And that's what he's played since he's joined Na'Vi. It's also interesting to see that Sonaco, who was one of the guys that was called out during the Na'Vi roster changes, that Sonaco was actually the one, like, being the most outspoken and leading the team at some points, that he's actually the man in the draft as chair for Na'Vi currently.
I think Na'Vi has been looking really good. General, sometimes when I watch his bet, it's very good, but then at other times he makes silly mistakes. Like, he gets way too aggressive, or he'll just poke his head out one too many times, and then he dies just randomly around the map. So I'm not going to say his Batrider is the best yet. You know, it's not an S4 Batrider, but he has a lot of room to improve. Mm-hmm. And I wish we had more time to talk, Toby. The draft is already almost
That's fine, man. We're going to have like 5 hours worth of talking coming up. Because it's not as though we're playing a push game with the Chedden and Enchantress on the field with Bounty Hunter sniping people nice and early on to give a huge amount of momentum. Or Queen of Pain, and we're still doing exactly the same kind of thing. So yeah, we're fine. We're fine, Reed. Just relax and just talk.
This is like a... This could be a 10-minute game, right? For either team. I mean, the Bounty Hunter, yeah, like you said, if he gets the ball rolling pretty early and they get these Enchantress ganks, I'm curious to see where they're putting people. It looks like Enchantress offlane, Zeus mid, Gyro. So they need a support hero here. Venge is pretty good in this situation. And, well, also, Disruptor is even better when you're thinking about going against the Wisp. Just plop that kinetic field back down, static storm on top, and then you can glimpse somebody back if the situation gets really sticky, so that's always nice to have. As whereas the Venge, it can only help you against the Batrider, doesn't give you that much AoE for the chin creep, so in the end, I do like Disruptor more. And let's see what Na'Vi want to pick up here. What carry will they pair with Io? Is it Sven?
You could be looking at Sven. You could just go back for the classic Tiny combo as well. 5 seconds remaining. But I'm wondering if that's even...
I mean, to blow up Enchantress, I think the best hero is got to be Tiny. Like, you just
That's what made me think of him to start with. But then I'm tossing up going, is that even the best hero to grab right now? Like, the laning presence of Team Spirit's not going to be amazing because Disruptor really isn't that terrific in zoning somebody out. So you could get away with, like, running a harder call. But... Okay, that's not what I was thinking.
We didn't see them run a carry earlier either. That's the thing, and they won against Team Spirit. They won.
They did, but at the same time, like, man, like I went back over the replay to watch like Arteezy's Aegis Prophet at MDL. I'm trying to work it out because, like, for me, like, I'm a big lover of Prophet. I'm like, well, okay, what are you gonna do, like? I can't call him Sun Ra, or else I get in trouble with Cap. Diddy Ra and a lot of other people. He went for a Hand of Midas build in the previous game. Like, and he was ganking with Midas and drums only. I say only, he had treads as well. But I'm sitting there going, okay, what do you really get out of having a Nature's Prophet in that one position? And I'm still baffling my mind about what can happen. Like, Arteezy went for this Orchid early build for control, and then your entire team just lacks damage in the late game. So that's why I'm sitting here looking at Team Spirit. Like, if they can delay this game, there's no one that's really going to force the issue up on high ground against them. If they don't, like, that's assuming Na'Vi don't have the pre-20-minute momentum.
Na'Vi are just going to completely dominate all of their lanes right now. Chen is going to either stack up and get a lot of levels, and Wisp is just going to go wherever he needs to be, you know, a fountain walking around the map. And then they're just going to keep putting pressure on with the Queen of Pain and the Batrider. All they need to do is just really get that fast mechanism on Chen. And the D push from Team Spirit only comes from Zeus. If they catch the Zeus out with, you know, a Queen of Pain with Orchid or a Lasso, it's pretty much over. Like, they have no D push. Of course, they have Gyro with call down too, but that's not going to be enough. And... yeah, one of your cores is going to have to stand on the front lines for Team Spirit, and they're just going to keep running at you and running at you with all the sustain. So I'm really worried for Team Spirit, but like you said, if it goes into the later stages of the game, they have a really great chance of just taking this because Gyro is the king right now.
It's the early movement. It's the early movement of Na'Vi and the ability to actually contest the lanes. And I look towards Artstyle. Like, I look towards Artstyle, who already bought up the early smoke. So yeah, of course, he's going to be looking to rotate. But the bounding's not going to let him get levels. And that's where I kind of like the question starts to beg, especially if this can happen. Then again, Ramsey's, he's dropping very, very low. The Wisp is going to be the first blood. The Gyrocopter will drop as well. So the Queen of Pain and the Enchantress will pick up the first runes, but they just keep pushing it all. The sticky napalm. Like, Team Spirit, they sat inside of it. It's still a 2-2 trade-off. So Naco's going to come back as this Wisp after respawning and TPing out. It'll be a triple kill for General. The Batrider off to a wonderful start. And Team Spirit are probably still sitting there asking themselves the question, what the fuck just happened?
Oh, man. You have a Zeus who goes Lightning Bolt during that situation, and he doesn't have, say, a Mengo in this situation, so he can't really clarity up in that battle to really put out all the arc lightnings. Imagine if he had arc lightning bouncing between four heroes.
Mm-hmm.
That would have been insane. And obviously, when you're fighting a Batrider, it's not scary until he gets like 3-4 sticky napalm. Then you just can't run away, and you automatically lose from that point on. So
it's like he got it because he was looking to check for wards early on. So it's almost maybe that was the greedy kind of way of Iceberg's play.
He wanted the first blood, which they got it. But at the end of the day, they only killed the Wisp off. Sure, they got the chin too. But still, your core, like you said, General. I mean, he's making out like a madman. He's gonna have his Trinkles really soon here, and he's able to punish this offlane now. He's got level 2, mm-hmm. almost level 3.
It's that issue which we're talking about, where Disruptor just he does jack all in the lane. So how are you meant to deal with this? Iceberg's gonna die again now here in the mid. As Dendi and Sineko just teaming up together, Arstal not even really being involved there. I want to look down to the bottom lane as well with this offlane of Team Spirit, Afterlife, taking up the role of the Enchantress up against the Nature's Prophet. Because currently, the Enchantress isn't really doing that great on CS. Sunra's been doing a great time there. And Goldblack rotates over. Are they actually killing off mid again?
Yep.
It doesn't even matter if Sineko takes this much damage. Like, you'll just heal it up. He gets a bottle 2 minutes in. Oh,
top lane, they're even going to go on the aggressive here with Ramzes. Even if he dishes out his damage, it's not going to be enough to really do... well, it pushes him back there just because he was close to his tower, but if he was even further away, that would have been another kill going to General.
How many times do you say a Gyrocopter is currently getting outlaned? it shouldn't happen with his early presence.
Always want to fly knees level 3. All right, he has it. But does he have enough mana for all the combos? Because you have to glimpse back into a kinetic field.
He's only got 2 stick charges. He'll need to have more. So there's your glimpse. No field. There's your go for the raw damage and the rocket barrage. There is, however, the stick charges up the sleeve of the Batrider, but General will finally die. Disruptor going to get some extra injection of levels as well as money for him, which ain't too shabby. And the Gyrocopter gets some breathing space on top.
That's just the... when your Firefly is down, you can't play as aggressive right there. And then Arstyle was probably deciding, hey, I'll come up and help you, but it was a little bit too late. Now that he's here, let's see what creeps he's got. He got a Troll and a Centaur. This will be enough to probably kill Ramzes. Oh, there's support, though, coming up.
Yeah, that TP just arrived from Goldblack. He's on the end of his double damage rune, so they've got the Troll Trap going on the Gyrocopter. General copying a little bit more damage than he's expecting to take, but always want to fly. He's the man that's been stunned up. Goldblack just keeps beating in. He doesn't really care. The Disruptor's going to help to get a revenge kill. So that's okay for them. That was the smoke gang from Artstyle, and with Iceberg's rotation as well, one Lightning Bolt as well as the Arc, he's going to ensure that last hit, and they can even mop up the rest of the Chang creeps. So not a bad rotation for Iceberg.
Really well played coming in from the rotations. I mean, Iceberg can't even go mid. He's just going to keep feeding. So what do you do in this situation? You can't go to the jungle as a Zeus. You just rotate it around. We still haven't seen Ditya roaming around, though. So he's just putting a lot of pressure on the Enchantress, like you said, completely dominating the lane. 10 and 6, the Enchantress versus the 17 and 12. You're pretty happy here. You're going to get level 6 first, and then... that's going to be the big thing, right? When Furion gets his level 6, they're going to have a huge global presence here. Oh, General, just looking out. They have a good ward here, scouting out what he wanted to do, but he didn't even need to do these creeps early on because he just got that triple kill at the beginning. So the ward was pretty much useless in the situation here.
Well, for now, they at least know General's alone up on that top lane, unless another TP is going to come over. This is the concern I was having, though, with Na'Vi. Like, it's a small little thing where, like, a couple of times, Team Spirit, that little fight in the top lane, it gives momentum back to Team Spirit. And this will allow Iceberg to get something like an Aether Lens, just have that long range. So Team Spirit's D-push will be there. And another fight like this, these early kills that you saw coming in for General, Like, they're just going to start working against it. The tether arrives from Sineko. They do get the kill over on Goldblack. It's finally Didira. He has his first influence in this game. That's giving instant two quick kills.
That helped Dendi out. Now he's back mid. He's farming away.
Thanks for the glimpse, boys.
Oh. Yeah, this is way too much aggression Na'Vi is putting out. Even though it's 8 for 6 right now, and it's 0, still, let's look at the EXP, though. Well, that's pretty much even, too. So, not as head as I thought it would be. So, not going too bad for Team Spirit, all in all. I guess the biggest thing right now is just the Zeus being shut down here in the mid lane. He's not going to have his fast level 6. Dendi's going to blink it.
He can just go for the whole thing. They can give us some mana up, and then just Sonic Wave as a guaranteed kill, and guaranteed it is. Denny, however, dropping very low. Goldblack copying a couple of balls to the side of the face, and now with the help, the rotation came in. It's a 2-for-1 trade-off. General's trying to come and be part of this fight as well. Go be careful. That level 2 glimpse is available for Always Want to Fly. As Denny Ryan going to TP himself in, Always Want to Fly did not send him back, however. So he's still adding some level of presence with that Wrath of Nature bouncing through it and ensures the kill over on the Enchantress. And now Team Spirit retreating back behind the tower, but Always Want to Fly, he's burning so hard. They try to ball him up. Iceberg as he TP'd in.
Ramses.
Try to find that moment between the burns of the Flame Break. But it wasn't enough, and Ramsey's going to catch out General in the tree line. Unless General can juke this. No, he cannot. The Gyro does find that last attack in.
Back down here. Toby in the river. He's chasing him. Oh, he has a level 2.
It's 15 one-charges as well for Goldblack. All he's got to do is just get that. It's a level 2 shuriken toss. And, wait, the Sprout locked him in. There's no more reveal on him. The Wisp Spirit's also coming down. It's going to help into Goldblack. Sineko just hit that last ball, and then he's good to go. Goldblack trying to dodge it for now. Sneaker's only got that for another 1 second. Oh. He pulls it in and Goldblack actually dodges the spin. The play by the experienced captain.
Goldblack might have missed a free kill there. Oh, mid lane. Once again, the aggression from the Wisp was the Queen of Pain.
Dead. Isn't it like the old... All right, is Always Gonna Fly going to be able to turn something here? Like, Sneaker's still got one charges. It's a trade. But now you're also trading your tier 1 tower in the mid. This is gone. Doesn't this just like bring up that whole idea of, okay, so what works as a mid? Major problem, there's no escape mechanism for these heroes. They have to be babysat so much. How do you babysit with a disruptor as well as a bounty hunter support? Is my question right now.
You don't, and that's the situation where the Wisp just thrives in this situation, and he's been doing a really good job. You don't even have to go back into the jungle stack. You just have complete rune control, and you keep putting the pressure on the Zeus. And the thing is, they're doing really well in all of their lanes, too, for the side of Na'Vi. Only thing that really kind of bit them in the butt was General. He's 5-3. He started off 3-1 or 3-0. No, he started off 3-0.
He was 3-0. He was 3-0.
Yeah. So he's just dying a little bit too much in the offlane. Given that great start, maybe that's the situation why Team Spirit is looking so good right now. But at the same time, he's still getting his levels up. He doesn't have Flaming Lasso. Does he have a point save?
He has
a point save.
Yep. Wonder what you're saving it for, though. Like, unless Flame Break, like, an extra level, and that's going to help you. A little bit of fun on bottom lane. Yeah, Goldblack's going to get sprouted up again. They dropped the Sentry Wards, that perfect vision. And Arsenal never holds back on that nuke.
Dendi's Roman. Hunting.
See, this is just... you don't have your level 6 over on Io just yet, but Denny doesn't even need help, but he's got it anyway. Like, it's the full global kind of strat. You're on a Wisp plus an Aegis Prophet. You can bring your team anywhere across the map whenever the hell you want, and then you just have the Batrider as that blinking, fire-flying initiation hero.
They're just cruising right now from Na'Vi, and... they lost one tower mid. They'll probably put the pressure on top. And the thing is, with Team Spirit's lineup, they only have Enchantress, who needs to get creeps to push fast. Like, they still have no answer to counteracting Na'Vi. And like I said, it's all on Zeus for the D-push.
Uh-huh.
And with Iceberg being shut down so hard, it's...
How do you also D-push? Like, you look at his build. He went for a 1-4-1-1 build. So you're actually going for what is generally labeled as the kill build. By having that 4 points up in the lightning bolt instead of having the arc lightning, which can sometimes be a little bit more farm orientated or just D push orientated.
They can even get the kill on here if they TP in with
You're looking at bottom lane?
No, Iceberg. They pinged it out. Art Style was saying,
General,
oh, he's going to go for the top.
You can't do that, bro.
He just gets it back.
He TP's into the tree line, so it made perfect sense, but then you just see this Firefly path of where he walked and just instantly gets taken out, like, with the glimpse. So they're having to do this with only a couple of other heroes, but it doesn't matter. When Denny's able to hit perfectly like that, the control of Art Style definitely helped. But it gets the kill overall and Disruptor for the committal of the Sonic Wave.
General's going to get run down here. He's already hit him once, and he's just waiting for his... Yep. That's level 6. That's a huge kill for Gallblack. And that's where Team Spirit can get back into the game. Track kills. But it's going to be very hard dealing with all the sustain coming in from Chin we've talked about. And it has to come from the good setup from Always Wanna Fly. He's trying very hard to get his level 6, but to no avail in the mid lane now. Hopefully he won't get relocated on. I hope I don't jinx him.
Even if that happens, you just be like, okay, screw it. Just glimpse one back. I've got a Zeus behind me. You should be able to survive. Like, Team Spirit do have a lot of sustain themselves for the D push because they're running around with double arcanes. So they can start spamming out a little bit more. And once the Enchantress starts getting a little bit more damage as well, like, okay, Gallblack, that was not his dream.
It's not the play.
Wrath of Nature is just too damn strong. I was thinking they could just play the range game with Impetus and everything else, but once again, Na'Vi close the distance. They get aggressive. They reveal the Blink Dagger for the first time of General. And what quickly follows is 2 kills. And they're actually going to relocate in Sonako. Wait, is that him coming back?
That's him just... I think the Chin sent him back. And then, you know, he's just relocating just to heal up Dendi and securing the tower, so... It's like a free trip for Dendi to the fountain here. I just like how they're doing a really good job, Na'Vi. Every single game I watch, they prioritizing protecting Dendi and making sure he has a great start. And every time that happens, he still makes the big plays, right, from Dendi. So he's doing an excellent job still in that mid role. We've seen a lot of people change up. Resolution went to the off lane. That didn't work out for him. He's back there. Obviously, he's on DC now. That was a big shocker. A lot of people said it was going to happen, though, but I didn't believe it.
Well, you know how gossip works in the scene.
It works. That's what it does.
You can normally believe half of it. Half of it is mistruth.
If it's from Bulba, it's true.
I don't know. Sometimes I think Bulba, like, people feed him information just to elicit information then coming out of somebody else. It's a fun little play to watch. Smoke up by Na'Vi. They do scout out Diddy-Ra. Gallblack's already gone invis there. And there's no Radiant Observer Ward or Vision up that hill. So they just want a quick kill. They're going to commit the call down. The Disruptor ulti. I don't even care if the Enchantress is dead right now. Zeus, who wasn't there, is the one who gets the kill with the Thunder God's Wrath. But he triggered his Arcane Rune. So he's okay with this. In fact, he's already done a significant amount of damage to Artstyle. But Always Wanna Fly, the Straggler, left behind. And Iceberg, the Hand of God from Artstyle. Gallblack really wants to come in. If he's going to get the track off with a Shuriken Toss bounce, they actually do get the track kill. That's a lot of money as well. Didn't realize Artstyle was worth so much. Almost 600 gold for that kill. And then Gallblack dodges the Sonic Wave. He had a crack. He had a guess. He wasn't certain where Gallblack was. But Gallblack will end up surviving through this. So a good pickoff for Trust there.
Yes,
and they're
going to
get another track kill. The Prophet's TPing in. Does he bring Dust with him? There's no invis anyway for Gallblack, so it's still a trade-off, but it's another track kill. You just start adding these things up now.
That's his mech. What the hell's going on here? Dendi?
Blimps is available. If there's an Observer Ward up. So I think Dendi understands he can't just blink himself away normally, because that could happen. And then he waits it out perfectly, dropping to 21 HP, but Thunder God's Wrath back off cooldown. Reveals the fact the Observer Ward's also on the hillside, but no one else from Na'Vi in range to gank for Team Spirit. The
seeds of fortune. That just came down to the haste rune. And if Dendi could have got it, he could have popped it immediately and then tried to run away faster. He wouldn't have gotten nuked down as heavily, but... Yep, Zeus' faster fingers, well played there from Iceberg. He's up to 2k gold now. And trying to figure out what he needs to stay alive. Oh, I can't even talk. Always Wanna Fly, sent back.
Yeah, he sent General back. So the last two gets wasted, throws out the ulti, realizes he's going to burn anyway. So just does as much damage to Diddy-Ra as possible. And allow the Enchantress to TP out with that control time. The bottom tower was denied by IO, however. So, Team Spirit not getting as much money as they were really searching for, but... Actually, no. I was thinking of an upside here, but there is no upside when Ramses gets ganked like that. This is feeling very similar to the Wii Play game these two teams played earlier tonight. The only difference is there's no Death Prophet doing pushing. There's a lot more ganking in this game. Like, we've already got 39 kills in 15 minutes. It's a very intense gank after gank after gank kind of play, but Na'Vi's just getting so much more out of it, and that's weird to say when you got a Bounty Hunter over on Team Spirit.
Yeah, the only thing they've managed to feed over to Team Spirit is a mech on the Bounty Hunter, but same time...
This timing.
Jeff is really lucky.
They can't find it. Always on a fly, doesn't have his ulti. General instantly gets aggressive, catching out Gold Black. Dendi unable to finish the job, however. Actually, no, I take that back. He actually does get him. He gets the Zeus as well as the Disruptor. And they blink forward after Afterlife. And this game may even be GG'd out before the 20-minute mark, even without the towers going down. Like, this is just a complete domination right now by Na'Vi across the map. And Dendi is beyond, like, anything. Like, he's 12-2-9 on his Queen of Pain.
I mean, he only has 55 CS. What does CS matter this game? I mean, Gyro is the highest, but that means diddly. They're just putting out, too much aggression. And there's no way Team Spirit can handle it because of their picks.
Yeah. I really would have, like... If you go back in the draft, you'd ask yourself the question, like, could you get something different to the Disruptor? Like, it made sense when you saw the Wisp there, but then you feared... You feared the relocate combo. If Itani was there, then maybe it would have made more sense. If they didn't have that Witch Doctor banned out in the fourth position... Maybe then that would have also been a better hero choice, because then they have something in the lanes. If they didn't give away the 3 kills to the offlane Batrider, maybe that would have been a better play.
True. Yeah, there's a lot of things, too. We can't just say it's about the draft because of how that level 1 engagement starts. So the lanes were pretty much skewed from that point on. But
Even if it was 3-2, it was the fact that like the stronger laning, like Nature's Prophet was going to be fine in the bottom lane no matter what. The Queen of Pain was going to be fine in the mid lane, kind of no matter what. You gave it to possibly the weaker lane of Na'Vi, which was the offlane Batrider. Relocating? They relocated for a kill. Tendi apparently locked inside the storm. Seneko, he's dropping so low. Finally, they get the kill before the Wrath of Nature gets a trade off, killing off Galblack. And with Didier'a arriving, always on a fly, too much damage being just put into him. Afterlife needs to help out Iceberg and does so to kill off Denny, and then Iceberg, oh, the TP's out! The perfect timing for both players, but Afterlife is completely stranded. He's got no extra life to really work with here. Like, 7-1 charges or not, like, he can't outrun this. That's a very good advantage.
But that's not gonna help you. It's so funny watching people try to kill Enchantress. It's like Ring Around the Rosie around the map. at least they do have magic damage to burst them down. That's the one good thing.
How does the Shadowblade into like Silver's Edge interact with Enchantress?
Yeah, it takes off the Untouchable, so that's a good counter. Nobody could really get at this game unless it's general crazy.
Didier'a.
Yeah,
he's already picked up the Shadowblade.
That's right, he got Shadowblade earlier in the game.
I was actually interested to see what his next item would be, because in the previous game, they never had time to see.
Right.
TP in. Looks like he was actually looking for a Courier Snipe at the same time. Arstyle's going to go down to Rams. He's had the BKB up, so he has some. He actually had some space to work with because of that, but this space is going to quickly be evaporated. The mech from Golbach will give him a little bit more fighting time, but then he just kept his distance nicely. They've only lost the Chen so far, so right now nothing of real DPS value has been lost. And Afterlife, well, he's silenced with that Orchid, and he will pop from just the Orchid damage anyway. So it's a triple kill for Dendi. And 35-17. An absolute bloodbath, but a lot more effective slashes from Na'Vi.
Oh, yeah. You can definitely feel the cuts going way deeper on the side of Team Spirit, and then they're almost out of blood, it feels. They did manage to take away Dendi's Aegis, but at the end of the day, he's still, like you said, is a monster. He's got his BKB now. There's no way he dies. There's none. You have to have an Ags now on Disruptor or a Sheepstick on one of your cores in the Enchantress.
Okay, I can answer your question right there. Never gonna happen. never gonna happen.
But if always happens, fly, not Toby.
If always in a fly picks up an Ag and Interceptor, it's because Na'Vi walked in as five men and kinetic field plus static storm surround them while Zeus was pumping everything in the middle of a cooldown, in the middle of fly cannon, with every single hero being tracked and hit by a shuriken toss, and Enchantress just pumping every single one of them down with Impetus. That's the only way. And then the Disruptor gets all five kills. That's the only way that an Agate Intercept would be possible for a Disruptor currently. Like, it's gotta be the dream play. And I hate to tell you that, like, the dream just is not a reality. Yeah, like,
I'm not saying there's a reality, but that's the only chance they have. I'm not saying it has to be that crazy, but they're gonna have to maybe save Dendi for last. Art style first is a good start.
Yeah, General, however, he's ready to go. Waiting for that blink with Sineko. No relocate save out. In fact, now Disrupt the roll. He's going to split this fight into two different paths, but Denny's BKB allows him to keep fighting. The Yule Scepter from Iceberg actually bought him a little bit of space. General, that Impetus, it's going to fly and kill him off. And it's actually going to be currently a 3-for-1 trade-off. Denny's on the run out of there. The Wisp will actually relocate, save himself. Unfortunately, I hate to say it for the Wisp, but this will not be a saving grace. His Glimmer Cape is still on cooldown, so there's no way he can play the Invis game here. So this is just a group up around a fresh track. Around a fresh track. They get the kill. He almost actually successfully TP'd out. But that's still so much money coming the way of Team Spirit.
What an amazing ballsy play. Like, it felt like that was the only play for them to make, too. If you sit back, you let Na'Vi get Roche, then the game, it looks almost impossible. But they found out art style. General didn't get off a good start there to the Flaming Lasso. He went for the Disruptor and always wanted to fly, already used all of his spells. He didn't get it off on the Gyrocopter in time because of the BKB. I don't know if he hesitated or if he had like 1 second left, because I don't think always want to fly got off his ulti in time. It just looks like General wasn't fast enough, or there was some kind of cooldown issue. But then, at the end of the day, he did get the Disruptor ulti off. Then, team fight lost from there. But Na'Vi definitely need to be a little bit more cautious. Iceberg, though.
Iceberg actually decides to Yule's over on Dendi, considering, oh wow, okay, Dendi blinks forward, he's gonna go for the Sonic Wave. Iceberg will survive thanks to that the Grease, which is already over on Goblack. In general, he tried to help out, he's tracked up himself, which gives the vision. Now they can glimpse him back, and they lock him down on the hillside. Diddy Raz looking for the pickoff. The sentry wall is down. They can see him with a lightning bolt down. Iceberg could just wait in the tree line. The Saturn Blast is so damn close. I'm fairly certain as well. That's the one that belongs to R-Style. Sineko trying to relocate, save out his teammate. And Iceberg, he's finally going to get beaten down with the last Hadouken over in the tree line. But R-Style's going to give up his life for this. And yes, you killed off the Zeus, but you're about to give more track kills. This is level 2 track now. The Team Spirit is playing with, you're giving more and more money to Team Spirit.
All right, I think. Oh man, Toby.
That's a 3.9k swing with just the three kills recorded, and that's including the Zeus's test. 3.9k, the bounty as well as the Enchantress got 1400. This Aghanim Scepter, is it even? It's fully done.
It is.
Fuck this. It was a 14,000 gold advantage, a 12,000 experience advantage. And because one terrible fight that happened over in the Radiant Jungle, and then a couple of follow-ups, Team Spirit are fully back in this game and capable of defending high ground.
Oh boy. This is very problematic. I mean, if Arsak could just get his Ags and he could have these huge creeps during the team fights, that would help out. Boosting up the HP is no small order, obviously, the Granite Keep. And then Ditya finally got off his Silver Edge. Maybe they could have dealt with the Enchantress a little bit better. But I think the biggest thing right now is them not blowing up Iceberg. He keeps surviving with his Yules, getting off his Thunder God's Wrath, as well as Lightning Bolt. They're going to try again on him.
Yeah, but Goldblack's also here. He's going to start with a track. Iceberg going to defensively Yules. Nice to drop their ulti going down. General's going to be caught in the middle of that one. Iceberg just spraying out every bit of damage he's got, but still it's not enough. Dendi gets himself a triple kill. And Afterlife just can't keep up with anyone else. In fact, he gets isolated inside the trees. They don't have another stun, however. So Afterlife will be able to escape.
Yep. Your Gyrocopter's not there, then there's no win for your team fight. That's what Team Spirit have to rely on. It It's because he has the BKB on Ramzes and he's able to pop it in the team fights and then have this huge AoE cooldown. It's allowing them to win team fights. But that was a good time for Na'Vi to really strike back, going into the jungle and then kind of invading and taking over. So now it's kind of back on Na'Vi. They got bumped it up a little bit, 2k lead. Back up to Nurt. It's up to 6k now, so it's not too shabby. I think the biggest thing right now is going to be the next Roche fight and how Na'Vi are going to try to attempt to take it, so we'll have to see.
I'm liking these item pickups now. So Arstar gets his Aghanim Scepter, so the Ancient Army will finally be assembled. But a Lotus Orb pickup from Goldblack is very difficult to keep the control on the Team Spirit Heroes now. Because you can't go on the bounty because he's just going to greaves off anything. So if you're trying to orc it on him, it's not going to work. And now you've also got the Lotus Orb, which will probably just try and protect the Zeus more than anything else.
And then and also can dispel the Silver Edge onto the Enchantress.
Ah, true.
I think that's even a bigger thing if they can get it off in time. Obviously, it's probably more for the Orchid and as well as the Flaming Lasso. So you can't dispel the Flaming Lasso, but you can obviously lasso yourself, and then you're just stuck there for General. So what is General? I feel like General has gotten zero items, and he's going for the Aether Lens right now.
I don't know if Art Style is... he has to have known. But he just used his Hand of God the second Thunder God's Wrath was used, and has still got the 130-second cooldown. The Aghanim's upgrade of the cooldown was removed. So there's almost like a 2-minute period where there's no Hand of God available now. And they only have minimal damage on the Na'Vi heroes.
That's kind of silly.
Yeah,
I agree with you.
But that's probably one of those things where it'd just be a reflex. Like, he's been playing Chen for a very long time. Like, it's just a... It's got to be a reflex action. Okay.
It's going to be very bad.
Goldblack just got hit by a Wrath of Nature. And they're moving over. So right now, Na'Vi probably think they've got an opportunity. And Team Spirit aren't going to try and capitalize. In fact, they just go into Roshan. Now, General's already on the fly. So he's going to see Ramzes walking out. Afterlife as well. BKB, Ramzes managed to get it off. But now we've put up on the cliffside. And we'll see who can really get the control. Ramzes is a little bit too far away to really be involved in this fight. And they had to wait for his BKB to end up before they can get him down again. But with that call down, Didira, he's gonna not get out of this one. In fact, the creeps moved in. Oh, he got killed by the neutral! Yeah, oh no! The neutral! They tried to use him up in the air, but it was all a little bit too late. So, ends up being a 1-0 trade off if we start counting denies. And with the observers in sentries down, Na'Vi will see Goldblack. Like, he'll end up putting himself inside the Lotus Orb, trying to hold it, like, protect himself, but it's just not enough. There was enough tick damage and basic physical damage, and Ramzes is still stuck here.
This is why you carry TPs. This is why. Also, a force staff wouldn't hurt.
One's coming out in the courier right now. So they try and fight Tanako. Okay, that's a lot of damage with Flakhand as well. Iceberg, he's going to Yule Scepter to buy himself some time to blink up, and now Lightning Bolt down the remainder of it. That's a Gem of True Sight also on the deck. Denny burns the TP just so he can pick up the gem. Doesn't have to drop the TP that way. A little bit quicker as far as efficiency of time goes. But there's four heroes lost for Na'Vi after they tried to finish off the job on the gyrocopter, but basically every hero of Na'Vi was in range of flat cannon.
Yep, that flat cannon just wrecked them. I never thought I'd see the day when a fireball would be effective. He was like set up there on the cliff and he couldn't move. Oh, so he just took the whole damage out mid.
Yeah.
Always want to fly once again. But that was a pretty funny team fight. If Ditya didn't die there, that could have early on to the Zeus and TPN, that could have been a huge team wipe coming in for the side of Na'Vi. But still, they're up and ready. 16 seconds on the gyro. They want to go into the ocean.
I'm gonna give it a shot, but they're right underneath the Dire Observer Ward. There is still a lot of vision out for Na'Vi, and with the gyro down for 3 more seconds and no tier 1 or tier 2 towers on the middle of the bottom lane, it would take time for Team Spirit to get there. Now, we see a weakness of the Na'Vi lineup that I was talking about. It's the lack of physical damage. Like, Didier is desperately trying to pick some up, but he's just not the same as most other cores. Now it's going to be Afterlife's turn, put up on the cliffside. How much damage can he do? The Lotus Orb will try and protect him. General is actually dying pretty damn quickly because Ramzes with that flat cannon again. General's going to drop. Roshan is opened up. And, well, Diddy Rise, is it worth the buyback right now? You're losing Arnstylus. Well, another track kill coming the way here of Team Spirit. The relocate's coming in. It brings Dendi to the front lines, but then he's caught inside the storm. He can't throw out his sonic wave. Dendi's down. It's a triple kill for Iceberg. You may as well make it a bloody ultra kill because the Wisp is being glimpsed back out. Couldn't even be saved by the relocate. And a track kill with four players still up. Roshan, Team Spirit started him 3, maybe even 4 minutes ago, and now they will finish him after Na'Vi has been denied.
That is not the play, to go on the Enchantress and put him on the high ground. I mean, they managed to get off, but once again, Ramzes is the king in the pit. Like, you just get a flat cannon and then called down twice in a row. It's like shame on me first time, and then how do you get shamed a second time? I just don't know. In that situation, so I think the biggest thing right now is the lack of the item progression coming in from General. Like he has 23 assists, 8 deaths, and 6 kills. So it's not that he's playing bad; it's just that he's getting no item progression, and he needs a BKB to really stand up and not just instantly die.
He's going for a different item build. He's going for an Aether Lens.
He's been working on this Aether Lens for the last 15 minutes. He had a blink and a force around 16, so. That's hurting the most in Na'Vi because, yeah, this is a timing. All about the timing, you're right. They have no physical DPS. That's why you're seeing Dendi here. Probably going for the AC first.
Oh, God Black. Always when a fly is going to give him the space to survive this. Looks like they send the Batrider straight back again anyway. Got to be careful, Team Spirit. Yes, you have an Aegis Immortal and a Monkey King bar and BKB over on Ramzes. That looks amazing for them. As goodbye, Dire Courier.
Good job, Ditya. You're the man.
He can't TP out of this, however.
He's got BKB, though.
Yeah, he's going to try and, like, he tries to play the Invis game. The wall gets put down by Always on a Flyer, so he BKB starts to TP. The damage output is just not enough. Instead, though, he TPs into the middle lane, which is where the fight's currently going on. Ramzes with the flag cannon. He's not doing anywhere near enough damage. So the bounty drops pretty quickly. Iceberg is catching up. Thunder God's Wrath's down, cooldown's down, but Team Spirit still seem to be chasing. They can't chase any further than this.
So, all right, well,
do you want to say space created, really? What Diddy Ride did, where he forced Team Spirit to bring two players back to the tier 3 tower, actually gave the opening for the rest of Na'Vi to attack in.
Yeah, he got really lucky he didn't die to the impetus. If that was a level 3 impetus, he was pretty much dead just because of the extra distance. And as well as Afterlife, he doesn't have that much attack speed right now going for the phase boost. So once he starts getting that online, most of these heroes are going to get melted from the side of Na'Vi. So have to be a little bit worried coming in from that side. But yeah, nice bait. I would say that's getting the courier. It was more so about that. And then, yeah, just killing off the Aegis there from the gyrocopter. So Na'Vi, they can definitely put on the pressure, and if they get one good pickoff, maybe they can go high ground finally.
I'm still not certain about that. Like, with the fresh Dr. Reen over on Zeus, he can basically de-push the entire wave by himself. Ramzes has more than enough damage that he can also hold him back. The Enchantress is on the same lines. The bounty, maybe not so much, but Goblack still got a lot of money thanks to all those track kills. Like, it's still... We have to keep in mind that this is a Bounty Hunter team which has found 33 kills in 33 minutes. Like, there's been a lot of money flooding into this guy.
Yeah, at least 18 tracks. At least, probably. So, he's been putting a lot of work in for Goblack here. Definitely keeping them in this game. If they didn't have the Bounty Hunter, the game would have been over already. So... that's one good thing about the pick here. Sure, it didn't help out early on, and then they weathered the storm. Na'Vi kind of... I don't even think they gave them too much, in the sense, whereas they just had a really nice smoke gank play that, you know, put them in. Oh,
relocate. Yeah, it's coming after Iceberg right now. Ramzes is going to go for the cooldown. Getting Sprout and control up a little bit, and he's actually locked in here a little bit too long. He started farming just because he had nothing else he could do at that time. Both Dendi as well as Ramzes will blow their BKBs. Both teams will also just retreat back out again.
Yep. Okay, so Zeus is dead, Toby. What we're saying?
What I'm saying still is going to stand. You've still got potential cooldown and fly cannon, which can stop any kind of push.
And you also don't know that the Zeus has buyback, so that's the biggest thing, too. Like, yeah, going into the gyrocopter there, sure, he might not have the BKB, but so does Dindy. His is on cooldown as well. So it's very risky to make that play. And you won't see the higher tier teams try to make those kind of risks.
Mm-hmm. And we got to the next... Okay, he's a while off, Roshan. I'm still wondering where the timing comes from Na'Vi. If you focus on finding kills, I can understand that. But, like, what do you expend to do this? If you got enough items over on the Nature's Prophet as well as the Queen of Pain, then I'm kind of okay with this. You assume that the next major item for a Gyrocopter is probably going to be a Butterfly. Which means Dendi has to be building into something more like a Monkey King bar himself. Nature's Prophet may be staring down that barrel too.
Yeah, if they do go for the Butterfly on the Gyro.
Do you think he does this game, or is it worthwhile for Ramsey to go more glass cannon kind of style?
He should get a Satanic. He's getting blown up pretty heavily. Like, the DPS is there from the Furion and the Queen of Pain because they didn't go for, you know, the Ags Octarine, and they didn't go for Ags Refresher, per se, on Dendi. They have a lot of physical DPS on their side, and it should not be underestimated how well these intelligence heroes can right-click right now. So... Satanic for me is a must for the Gyrocopter in this situation. After that, probably a Butterfly. So you want to make the enemy teams go into MKB.
It just stops other game-ending items. Like, Denny's actually going for full DPS. I was expecting him to get something, but I wasn't expecting a Daedalus out from him. But currently he's walking away with a Crystallis. Gallblack. He just helps keep the vision up on Art Style. So a quick pullback and a four-man track kill from Team Spirit. And they may get more. Nope. Danny's just blink, taking him far enough away. And looks like you're right.
Okay.
Not taking him far enough away, obviously.
Did you see that?
I did not. I really wish I did. Can you explain what happened? I thought he was home and hose. That's why I looked away.
Dindy turned around and right clicked him twice, and he just zapped him with the lightning bolt and ulti.
Yep. So Dendi was away, but he chose to, like, reinsert. Okay.
Yeah. And he didn't pop his BKB. I mean, I wasn't even sure that was going to be that much DPS coming in. That was absurd, the amount of damage coming in.
At least I can enjoy this DPS. Dira, a very quick and efficient kill over on the Disruptor. This is just too damn easy, however. I'm going to relocate him down. Oh, the Snake is so far away, they're going to catch him. This is very, like, you've played a couple of games with me, right, when I played Nature's Prophet?
Yeah.
This is actually, if you remove the BKB, this is my build.
I haven't played with you recently.
This would have been like a year ago, man. But this is what I class as Crit Prophet.
Oh, yeah.
The problem is, because, like, you use the Maelstrom into Mjolnir, it gives you all your attack speed to keep farming and split pushing, and you buy yourself the space. You'd never really have to drop the Hand of Myers because you'll have your attack speed and just the level up of everything. Around this point, you drop it because you don't need it for anything else, really. You're already getting enough money from across the map. You get the Shadow Blade, which allows you, again, to have that security in the side lane pushes. In this case, it makes a lot of sense to develop into a Silver Edge because you're up against the Enchantress. Not to mention, it's like your only strength item you'd normally get. The BKB is if you're up against a crap ton of magical damage, which in this case he is, and then you go into a Daedalus. And when you have the Daedalus with this kind of build, the amount of damage you pop out, like, Iceberg is going to lose half of his life just on the first hit as you come out of your Silver Edge. Now he's going to Yule Scepter up and try and avoid this gank out from Na'Vi. That won't really last for long after D throws the ulti out. And now they just profit as well. Here's your DPS player up against Ramsey. He's got the Satanic on, but they're actually winning the DPS battle with a blink down from Dendi. He helps to get the end kill on the Disruptor. And Team Spirit will lose four heroes. Now they'll have issues because now they've got no D push. And he only just bought the bloody Crystallis. Now he's got the full Daedalus on the Nature's Prophet. Oh, I love it.
I mean, that's just the AC factor coming in for that T fight. Like, and you don't have any attack speed on your gyrocopter. You just get bullied down by these two heroes. As well as the biggest thing, Silver Edge isn't the only counter to the Enchantress. You just pop your BKBs, and what the hell does an Untouchable do? So they just pop both their BKBs, right-click the Enchantress in like two hits. It was really impressive to see that. And then now they're in the driver's seat. They already got one Rax. There's a buyback, and they're not even going to back.
No. Well, there's not much reason to. Like, yeah, you don't have your Sonic Wave, but your physical damage is still more than enough. You can guarantee yourself a Rax and a half. The Silver Edge is also okay. Well, he is tracked up, so maybe D-Rod doesn't get out of this one perfectly fine. But if Goblike chases any further, then he'll find himself dead.
Yep.
That's a Rax and a half. That's the cost for the Aghanim's on Disruptor.
Well, that's... Seems perfectly fine, right? You said he wouldn't get it this game, Toby, and I'm gonna...
Well, at the same time, I didn't think Na'Vi would throw two fights under the Roche Pit either, but that's... I'm just saying that.
Nope, Toby was wrong, guys. He's not a man enough to admit it here. But yeah, you're right. In all seriousness here, it would take a miracle right now, right? It has to be all on this Ags coming in from Always Wanna Fly to really turn the tides. Because the BKBs have made Zeus very underwhelming. Goldblack, there's only so much he can do in these situations. He's been doing great so far. Do they have a gem? No, they don't. Is it on general?
Did have a gem. The gem's
it's on general. They see him now.
Oh, Goldblack. BKBs, but it's all too late. The damage had already arrived in Iceberg. Well, he's chasing him up to something else, but he's not going to find anything. So the BKB is burnt from the Enchantress. Ramsey still has his. But they're staring down Roshan with the top lane pushing in too hard. And in fact, already Nature's Prophet's trying to capitalize on this. They even relocate Dendi in. Sonego can break the tether so they don't have to take him back. Now, General won't get there as well, but at least he's delaying Afterlife's return. And in fact, Didira just rotates over, uses the Silver Edge, and now you start to see the damage kick in. Yeah, they realize this game is over. There's no way Team Spirit can stop the push. They're up against Megas now. Game was good. And game will go into a second.
Yep. That was Na'Vi just having the better core items and just building into them better. And then obviously in these later game situations, it really does come down to the pickoffs. And when you have Batrider, Nature's Prophet, and Wisp, you can be anywhere on the map. And you saw what happened, right? The Iceberg just died top lane. And then once he fell, all their DPS seems to be gone. We saw the man fight coming in from Ramses, but... He doesn't have that other extra item that he needed. He needed either the butterfly to really help out with his attack speed or an AC. Like if they had an AC on the side of Team Spirit in that last team fight, I think they would have won it just because then they could have had that extra attack speed on Ramses or something. But at the end of the day, Na'Vi win it. It could have been, you know, a 15-minute GG for Na'Vi, but instead we got a really thriller 41-minute game.
And it definitely... It reminds me not to gamble on who's going to win a game. It was fun back and forth. It's how I'm going to describe it. Game 2 is coming up. It looks like Na'Vi is going to keep their run. Not a single game lost since Starladder. Can they keep the run going? We'll be back after this short break to find out.